Hi everyone, welcome to Organic Creations. I hope you all are doing fine today. So we are back here today with a new recipe, a new soap recipe. And today I'll be making something very different, a new recipe which I have never tried before. We are going to be making a rosemary and tea tree cold process soap. And I have been getting a lot of messages, from people asking me to share the exact recipe of the soap with the measurements. Now here, because I make a little bigger batch, I just share it, in the percentages, because I know it's not convenient for beginners to make a big batch of soap when you're just trying out, soap making for the first time, or you're just a beginner. So in today's video, I will be posting a recipe in the description box, which is for a very small batch of soap, about 500 grams. Which is okay for any beginner to try, and make a 500 gram batch of soap. So I will be making my regular batch of soap, but in the description box, I will be giving you the exact measurements of a smaller batch of soap, which you can try it out for learning purpose. So let us start with the soap that we are making today. Here I have taken my blend of oils and butters. I have already cooled it down. Even I have my live water solution, which is cooled down, and we can now begin. Now, since we are making a rosemary soap, rosemary is extremely good for your skin, especially people with a oily skin who have a lot of problems with acne. Their skin getting oily very fast. This rosemary is an extremely good thing to be used for the skin if you have this oily skin problem. And we are going to blend it with tea tree oil, which is again very, very good for oily skin. So basically this soap, especially for the people having skin problems, a lot of acne and oily skin. So I'm going to be adding this rosemary powder in my oils here, and I'll give it a blend. Okay, so here I have nicely blended my rosemary powder in the oils, and now I will be adding the lye water solution in this. Okay, and now we'll give it a blend again, and we'll make sure that it doesn't get very thick, because I will be adding a little Cambrian blue clay to this as well. Okay. So now I'll just pour this in two different containers. And in one of the batch, I will be adding my Cambrian blue clay here. And again, this Cambrian blue clay is very, very good, excellent for the skin to remove all the impurities from the skin and help it give it a nice youthful look. Okay, so I have blended this Cambrian blue clay here, and I'll be adding my tea tree essential oil in both these containers. And I'll just give it a mix. We have blended both this well here, and now we will start with the pouring of the soap. Okay, so first I'll be putting the white base down here. This has thickened a little, but it's fine. Here I'll just put a little bit of the Cambodian blue clay batter here. And I'll just give it a little swirl, not much. We'll just try a little. This time I want to try a different texturing altogether. So let me see how that turns out to be. Okay, and we'll just wait for about 5 minutes before we pour the this batter on top, because I just want this, like, you know, two different colors. I don't want it to get into each other. Okay, so now we will pour this the other batter on top. It's already thickened. And now we can give it the texture, because it's already quite thickened. I'm giving it a very simple texture, not something really complicated. I think simple looks better. Okay, so I have textured this, given this a texture here, if y'all can see this. And now I'll just spray this with 99% rubbing alcohol. Okay, so now we'll keep this to dry for about 24 hours. And after that, I'll see y'all for the cutting of the soap. Okay, so friends, we are back here today with this soap. It's 24 hours now that I had kept it in the mold. And it's all dried up well. This is how it looks. The color that we had put of the Cambodian clay, it's turned out to be, it's got this grayish tinge. and let us cut and see how the soap looks from inside. Okay, so this is how the soap looks from inside. I hope you can see it. It's got this gray color on top, and down we had left it plain. So this is how it looks. Also friends, as I told you that I will be putting in the description box, I will be putting the recipe of 400 grams bar of soap. So, you know, even for the beginners who want to try out soap making, and you know, who are trying it for the first time, can easily make that batch of soap, you know, for trying purpose and see how it works out. So you can get that in the description box. See, this is how the soap is turned out. And also friends, you know, I've been getting a lot of questions about the measurements of lye and water. Now, what I want to tell you is, in the soap making, you know, calculations are very important. You cannot go wrong with your lye and water calculation and the oils. So, you know, it is very important that you measure the lye, water and the oils correctly when you're making the soap. Otherwise, it will not turn out well. And also, you know, people who are making, who just want to make a small batch of soap just for their personal use, can definitely use the recipe which I am posting in this description box. But if anyone is interested in, you know, you know, if they want to do a business in soap making or anything, what I would suggest is that you need to do a lot of research on how to calculate, you know, the amount of lye and water that you need to add in your soaps. You'll need to do a little bit of research before you'll get into this. Because that's very necessary. It's not as simple as just, you know, seeing the formula and making the soap. There's a lot of practice that goes into making of soap. So, you know, it's my personal suggestion that you all watch few more videos. Just go on the net, check for how we calculate the lye, and accordingly you can, you know, start formulating your own recipes. Okay, and about the soap that we have made, also I would like to tell you, this soap is you know, more or less a you can say it's like a medicated type of a soap. Since it has rosemary, I couldn't really explain to you all the benefits yesterday while making the soap, but rosemary is excellent for any type of skin related problems, like you know, itching in the skin, these types of skin irritations that you get, some types of skin infections. I won't say that this is going to you know, it's going to cure any skin problems, but definitely it is going to give you a lot of relief if you're having, you know, if you're facing any such skin problems. Using this is only going to, you know, reduce it and help you deal with it and manage with it better. So it's more or less like, you can say it's like more of a medicated soap, because we have tea tree in this, we have rosemary. Okay friends, so here we are done with the cutting of our rosemary and tea tree soap. Y'all can just have a look at it here. So these are all cut here, and now just after some time I will just stamp them as well. And friends, if you like my video, if you're learning something out of this, if it's helping you in some way, please do like and subscribe to my channel and share it as much as you can, even with your friends or anyone who's interested in learning how to make soaps and you know, other beauty care products. And thank you so much friends for all your support so far. Thanks a lot. Bye.